In this video, I will show you how to set up your workspace according to your individual preferences. We'll demonstrate how to change the size and the layout of the visual elements and how to create a customized perspective. We already talked about the preset perspective, so the preset layouts of the user interface that come with Snow Owl. What you see here is the authoring perspective. That gives you access to most of the functions of the software. If you do mapping, you might want to use the mapping perspective by just clicking this icon in the toolbar where you see the SNOMED CT concept views on the left side and the ref set view, and on the right side the ICD-10 view and the editor in the middle, so you can map from one terminology to the other. If you're working with ref sets, the ref set perspective might be handy because it has only the ref sets view and the editor. So if you're opening a ref set, for instance, this one, then the editor will be displayed and the whole screen can be used just for the ref set view and for the editor. But let's go back to the authoring perspective. You see now my reference set editor is already here in the middle. Let's start with opening and closing views and editors. It's quite simple. You just press, click this close icon. You can also right click a tab and then close it here. So if I would like to have more space for my SNOMED CT concepts, I can simply close all the tabs in the section below, and then this window will be expanded. You can, of course, also expand the size of a window just by simply dragging the border. This. But if you don't need a view, it makes sense to close it. Then the whole section disappears. I'm going to close this one as well. And now, you open a concept, you have a lot more space for the editor, or for several editors as well. If you want to close an editor, you can right-click it, and there is the option of closing all editors at the same time, or closing the others, so not the active one, but all the other ones. Let's do this. You see now the other one disappeared. If you have a lot of editors open, what is going to happen is that a small symbol will appear that shows you that some editors are hidden. And you can click it, and then the one that is in bold is actually the hidden one. And if you click it, then this one will be open. You can either close all, just this one, or close all the others. Let's close them all. Okay. So if you're happy with this view, with this perspective, you can save it by clicking Window, Save Perspective, and then you can type in a name for your perspective, or I already created one that is called Browsing that I will overwrite now, and then I click OK. It warns me that I'm overwriting a perspective. There is no function to delete a perspective, so you might want to overwrite one that you don't need anymore. And now actually on the owl icon, this is my customize perspective. So if I go to reference it, for instance, and then I go back, I have my browsing perspective. If I would like to have my authoring perspective again, I need to go to Window, Open Perspective, and then there's Authoring. If you go to Other, you have access to all of the perspectives that are out there. So you see there's the authoring default perspective. If I click it, I get my authoring perspective back. And there's actually two owls now. One is for the browsing perspective and one is for the authoring. So I can switch perspectives. Okay. A few things I haven't talked about is you can move a view by grabbing the tab and moving it to the side. And you see when I grab it and I keep the button pressed, then the mouse pointer changes in a stack, and then I can just drop it in the stack, or I can drop it as part of another stack or down here. However, there's another possibility. I'll show this to you as editors. Let's open to editors. If I grab this and it turns into an arrow, then it will be docked on the side of this section. So I have two editors side by side. Now if I double click this and then I use the entire screen, and this is quite useful when you're editing, then you have and you want to have two editors side by side. Make it smaller again. Okay. Another function is minimizing and maximizing. You can maximize a window simply by double-clicking the tab. When you double-click it again, it restores it, or you can maximize it with this icon, and then there's this little restore icon on the side. This works as well with some editors. So double-clicking brings up, for instance, the reference set editor. Double-click it again, restores it, maximize, and restore. So you can either use this, or you can double-click, and you can then use that to restore. So it doesn't matter what you do, either double-clicking or using the icons. Whenever you maximize a view or an editor, all the other components will still be represented by icons here in a trim stack. So trim stacks will appear, and with these you can restore the section here. So now we've got restored it. Let's do it again. So you restored it. But if you just want to look at one of the views, you just click the icon and you can see the tooltip shows you which icon it is. So if I, for instance, need the ICD-10 terminology, you just click this and it kind of opens up like a drawer that is above on top of the reference set editor. If you click it again, or if you click somewhere else, it disappears. So it's not really open it up, it just puts it on top of it. You can do this with all the other things if you need your bookmarks, for instance, or if you want to have the task list, so just like this. So you still have access to all of the other elements by clicking these icons, or if you want to restore it, just click this. Or double click. Okay, that was basically all I wanted to say about changing your layout, and that's it for now. Thank you.